In this illustration, we'll discuss about a pendulum clock in an elevator car. Here we are given that a pendulum clock is mounted in an elevator car which starts going up at a uniform acceleration A, where A is given less than g, acceleration due to gravity. And after ascending a height h above the starting point, direction of acceleration is reversed, keeping its magnitude constant. And we are required to find the time after start of motion when clock will show the right time again. So here in solution, first we can see time when A is upward, because initially the car is going up at an acceleration A. So the time when A is upward can be directly written as root 2h by A, because up to a height h it travels over an upward acceleration A. And if we calculate the angular frequency of a clock, we are talking about a pendulum clock, so we consider it like a simple pendulum. So angular frequency of clock in ascending elevator is, this angular frequency can be given as root of g plus a by l, because in an elevator going up, effective gravity can be taken as g plus a. This we already discussed. And we know that the actual angular frequency of clock when elevator is at rest on earth can be given as root of g by l. So here you can see it is increased. So as angular frequencies increase, clock will become faster and it will gain time. So we can calculate in this time the number of oscillations or angle, or you can also call it the phase gained by clock in time t, which we can also call as upward motion with acceleration. This can be given as angle phi 1, which is equals to this omega t is the time or the angle or the phase change while it is accelerating up, and actually it should be root g by l t. So this can be written as root g plus a by l minus root of g by l multiplied by t. The time here is root 2h by a. Now after time t, and the acceleration direction is reversed. That means the elevator is going up, but it is retarding as the direction of acceleration is in downward direction. So we can write after reversal of acceleration, angular frequency of clock is, this we can write as omega prime, and the value we can write, this can be written as omega, not the actual frequency. So omega prime here will be root of, this can be written as g minus a by l, because in an elevator having downward acceleration, the effect of gravity can be written as root g minus a. So if we consider a time t1, if in time t1 is the time we are taking after the acceleration is reversed, in time t1 after direction of a changes, clock loses the phase by angle phi 2. This implies here the value of phi 2 we can write as root of g by l minus root of g minus a by l multiplied by time t1. Because as clock angular speed goes down, that means it becomes slower, so it will start losing time. So in a time t1, the total time lost or the angle or phase or oscillations lost by the clock can be given by root g by l, which is the actual angular frequency minus the slow angular frequency multiplied by time t1. And we can say if after T1, clock shows write time, and this implies clock will show write time if phi 2 is equals to phi 1, that is the time gained by the clock in upward accelerated motion of elevator, when it becomes equal to the time lost by the clock in downward accelerated motion of elevator, it will show the write time. So this we can further simplify. We can equate these two values which are giving us root of g plus a by l minus root of g by l multiplied by time t. We can write as root 2h by a, which we already calculated. This is equals to root of g by l minus root of g minus a by l multiplied by t1. So simplifying this, we'll get the value of t1, which is given as root 2h by a multiplied by root of g plus a minus root g divided by root g minus root of g minus a. So this is the time after reversal of direction of acceleration when clock will show the right time. But we are required to find the time after start of motion. So this can be written as total time t naught, after which from a start it will show the right time. So this will be t plus t1. So t is root 2 h by a. If you simplify this, finally the result you'll be getting is, I'm leaving the calculation part, and we can directly write down the result as this is root 2 h upon a multiplied by, this will be root of g plus a minus root of g minus a divided by root g minus of root g minus a. So this will be the final result of this problem.